Major funding for the production of Granite State Challenge has been provided by Unitil, Energy for Life, NEA New Hampshire, with additional funding from D.F. Richard, Markham Image, Heinemann Publishing, Measured Progress, the NEEF Networks for College Planning, and by viewers like you. Thank you.
Get ready. It's time for New Hampshire high schools to match wits in a high-stakes scholastic showdown. It's time for Granite State Challenge. Here's your host, Jim Janot.
And thank you, and hi, everybody. Welcome to another game of Granite State Challenge, week number 7 of our opening round of competition this year, in year number 31 for Granite State Challenge, a season that really began back in November when we had 54 high school teams come together at Plymouth State University on Granite State Challenge Super Sunday. They competed over a 100-question exam. Top 16 scorers qualified for play this year. Two of those teams are here tonight. But before we introduce you to them, let's look back on that big Sunday in November. It was a fun day and an intense day, and it resulted in our 16 teams participating this season. Two of those teams here tonight, let's introduce you to them. First of all, we have the team from Hanover High School. Hanover High School, with an enrollment of some 759 students, it is located in Grafton County.
Hi, I'm Toby, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Raj, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Ben, and I'm a senior.
I'm Felix, and I'm a junior.
With us for the program, the coach for the team, Bill Murphy. His alternate today is Kevin Heibels, and they are the Marauders of Hanover High School. All right, let's introduce you now to their opponents for tonight's opening round game. This is the team from Plymouth Regional High School. Plymouth Regional has an enrollment of some 684 students and is also located in Grafton County.
Hi, I'm Alexander, and I'm a senior.
Hey, I'm Sean, and I'm a sophomore.
Hi, I'm Isaac, and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Andrew, and I'm a junior.
The team is coached by Jay Fogarty, and his alternates today are Riley Karp and Kyle Sanders, the Bobcats of Plymouth Regional High School. And our last introduction is to let you know who our judges are this season. Once again, we welcome Jim Johnston and Ann Belanger. Okay, you've had all the introductions. Now let's play the game. We have opening round of 10-point toss-up questions. Then we'll get on into a bonus and 60-second round. But right now, Hanover and Plymouth, these are 10-point toss-ups. Good luck. Here we go. The 1925 Butler Act prohibited the teachings of evolution in this state that was later the site of the Scopes Monkey Trial. Felix of Hanover.
Tennessee.
Tennessee is correct. This female rapper is known for the songs The Rain, Super Duper Fly. Zan of Plymouth.
Missy Elliott.
Missy Elliott is correct. She played the elf Arwen in the Lord of the Rings trilogy and is the daughter of the lead singer from Aerosmith. Zan of Plymouth.
Liv Tyler.
Liv Tyler is correct. Is thatch a kind of nut, a cloud of insects, or a matted layer? Felix of Hanover.
A matted layer.
A matted layer of decayed vegetation is what it's going to be, but you are correct on your answer. All right, let's go with the next 10-pointer. Unlike a call, this bird communication is a series of sounds in a... Felix of Hanover.
Sonar.
I can repeat it for Plymouth. Unlike a call, this bird communication is a series of sounds in a fairly definitive pattern. What is it? Azan?
A song?
A song is correct. The New Hampshire state motto, Live Free or Die, comes from a statement written by this Revolutionary War general. Sean of Plymouth?
John Stark.
John Stark is correct. This woman became queen of the United Kingdom at the age of 18 when William IV died. Sean of Plymouth?
Victoria.
Queen Victoria is right. This author is known for works like Stranger in a Strange Land, the Zan of Plymouth.
Camus.
I can repeat it all for Hanover. This author is known for works like A Stranger in a Strange Land, The Moon is a Harsh Mistress, and Starship Troopers. Tobias?
Robert Heinlein.
Heinlein is correct. This author, who won a Pulitzer Prize for the novel The Bridge of San Luis Rey, also won a Pulitzer Prize for a play he wrote set in New Hampshire. Felix of Hanover.
Thornton Wilder.
Thornton Wilder, writer of Our Town. We have a photo for you to look at. Take a look here, and I'll ask you the question. This founding father defended Sean of Plymouth.
John Adams.
The British soldiers involved in the Boston Massacre. Indeed, it was John Adams. June 12, 1963, this civil rights leader was shot and killed. Zan of Plymouth.
Martin Luther King.
I can repeat it for Hanover. June 12, 1963, this civil rights leader was shot and killed in his driveway in Jackson, Mississippi. The shooter, Byron DeLabeckwith, was finally convicted for the murder in 1994. Raj?
Malcolm X.
It was Medgar Evers. Medgar Evers. Paper and pencil in front of you if you think you might need it for a math question. If 30 students are in a classroom shaped like a rectangular solid with dimensions of 15 feet by 30 feet by 12 feet, what is the average number of cubic feet per student? We'll give you a little time there. 30 students in the classroom shaped in a rectangular solid, dimensions of 15 by 30 by 12. Andrew of Plymouth?
180 cubic feet.
180 cubic feet. Well done. This comedian was the creator of the HBO show Curb Your Enthusiasm. Zan of Plymouth?
Larry David.
Larry David is correct. Tom Wolfe's first novel, The Bonfire of the Vanities, was conceived of as a serial in the style of Charles Dickens. It was originally published in 27 installments in this magazine, best known for covering music. Tobias of Hanover.
No. Rolling Stone.
Rolling Stone is correct. What is the distinguishing feature of a satellite in the geosynchronous orbit? Tobias of Hanover.
It stays over the certain same point on the Earth.
That is correct. This senior senator from South Carolina is also a colonel in the U.S. Air Force Reserve. Zan of Plymouth.
Jack Kerouac.
Hanover. Felix.
Walker.
It is Lindsey Graham, Senator Graham of South Carolina. The Iraqi invasion and occupation of this country at the tip, Tobias of Hanover.
Kuwait.
Correct, at the tip of the Persian Gulf is one of the factors that led to the Gulf War. This Canadian singer was discovered in 2007. Tobias of Hanover.
Justin Bieber.
Justin Bieber is correct. In 1989, the Ayatollah Khomeini issued a fatwa calling for the assassination of author Salman Rushdie because of this book, Raj of Hanover.
Satanic Verses.
Satanic Verses is correct. The light-sensitive cells in the retina. Sean of Plymouth.
Cones.
I can repeat it all for Hanover. The light-sensitive cells in the retina are of two types, rods and cones. Researchers believe that there are three kinds of cones, each sensitive to what three colors? Tobias.
Red, green, and blue.
That is correct. What is the cause of the color changes in the appearance of Mars as seen from Earth? Tobias of Hanover.
Atmospheric distortion.
Plymouth. Sean.
Diffraction of light.
Really specifically, dust or dust storms. And there's the whistle ending our round. Very high scoring and very well played first round. Well done, everybody. Hanover holding on to a slim lead, 100 to 80. Before we get to the bonus round, though, we're going to take a timeout. Lori Warner is with us again this week. Happy to have her back as she now talks with the team from Hanover.
Well, thank you, Jim. And first, we will start our interviews with Raj. Now, Raj, you are a runner.
Yes, I've been running cross-country and track since middle school, and I really like it. I do long and mid-distance running, so longest I go is like 5K for cross-country, but for training, might go up to 10, 15 miles, and I think it's fun, yeah.
I hate driving 10 or 15 miles, so I'm glad that you like that. And Ben, we have you now. You're on your way to France for the summer.
I am. It's really very exciting. I'm going to be able to work on my language skills and get to meet a family that we speak in French the entire time. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Hopefully you're all set when you get there to ask for the basics.
Yeah, definitely. It's going to be very nerve-wracking, I'm sure, the first few days, but hopefully I'll get used to it.
It should be a lot of fun. Okay, and next we have Felix, who is a big Chicago fan, we've established.
Well, yes. In fact, I was born there and have since transplanted my allegiances here. I am still a Cubs fan and a Bears fan especially. And I just want to say that Ryan Pace, if you're watching this, Jay Cutler has to go. He's a poison to the Bears.
And I'm sure he is watching, so, and hopefully he'll be taking your advice on that. Okay, let's see, and now Tobias, you are on the student council.
Yes, I'm a senior, and this has been my fourth year on student council. I've helped plan our school's winter carnival, and this year I'm the treasurer, so I get to handle the money.
That's awesome. Well, I hope that you can handle all these questions that Jim's got for you, so we'll head back to the game, and you, Jim.
Hi, thank you very much, Lori. And that's the team from Hanover right now holding on to a slim 100-80-point win, or lead, that is, over Plymouth. We come to our second round. This is our bonus round. We'll still be asking the 10-point toss-ups. The team that gets it correctly has a chance at bonus points. So good luck. Big round, Hanover and Plymouth. Here we go. Prince William, Duke of Cambridge, who is currently second in line to the British throne, is likely to be the first British king descended from the Stuart king who ruled Great Britain from 1660 to 1695. Zan of Plymouth.
George IV.
Good try, Hanover. Raj.
Cromwell.
It was Charles II. In 1940, Joseph Stalin ordered the assassination of this founder and first leader, Tobias of Hanover.
Trotsky.
Trotsky is right, the first leader of the Red Army. So let's go over to Hanover for your first opportunity at bonus points. Tobias, you are the team captain. You speak for them, and let's talk to them and choose from Legal Eagles, Push It Real Good, or Mark Up. Legal Eagles, Push It Real Good, or Mark Up.
I think we should do Mark Up for Mark.
Okay.
Mark Up.
Let's go with Markup for 5 points apiece. And again, Tobias, I take your answer for the team after you talk to them. Identify the following famous marks. This businessman owns the Dallas Mavericks and is also on Shark Tank.
Mark Cuban?
Correct. He played Luke Skywalker in Star Wars, The Empire Strikes Back and Return of the Jedi.
Mark Hamill.
Correct. His real name was Samuel Clemens.
Mark Twain.
Easy enough for 15 out of 15 on the bonus. We go with a 10-point toss-up. On December 12th, 1901, this man transmitted the first wireless signals across the Atlantic Ocean. Tobias of Hanover. Say again.
Marconi.
You are correct for 10 points. So back to Hanover we go. We still have Legal Eagles and Push It Real Good, and we'll add Alien Invasion.
I like Alien Invasion. Alien Invasion.
Let's go with the Alien Invasion for 5 points apiece. Identify the following fictional space aliens. He loved Reese's Pieces.
E.T.
Correct. The battle cry of these creatures on Doctor Who is exterminate, exterminate.
Daleks.
Correct. This space alien was adopted by the Kent family when he was a baby.
Superman.
Clark Kent is absolutely right. Let's go with a 10-point toss-up. The U.S. Military Academy is located in this town. Raj of Hanover.
West Point
in New York. Right back to Hanover we go. And we'll clear that out, and we'll just say Legal Eagles, Push It Real Good, or Do You Speak English?
Let me try Push It Real Good. Push It Real Good.
Let's Push It Real Good. Boring. For 5 points each. Identify the following related to pushing. In Greek mythology, this Sisyphus. King had to push a boulder up a hill only to have it roll back down again.
Sisyphus.
Correct. This creature in Dr. Doolittle has two front halves joined in the middle and facing in opposite directions.
Push me, pull ye.
This political campaigning technique uses a survey with leading questions not to gather information but to influence voters.
Bait
and switch.
No. Voter push.
It is a push poll. 10 out of 15 on the bonus. Here's your 10-point toss-up. What is the geometric mean of 3 and 5? The geometric mean of 3 and 5. Tobias from Hanover.
4.
Plymouth? It is the square root of 15. All right, we have a photo. Take a look at the photo. I'll ask the question. In his poem, Concord Hymn, this poet refers to the first shot taken in the Revolutionary War by a Patriot fighter as the shot heard round the world. Sean of Plymouth.
Longfellow.
Good try. Hanover. Felix.
Ralph Waldo Emerson.
It was Ralph Waldo Emerson. So we get back to you, Hanover. For Legal Eagles, do you speak English and all the small things? Legal Eagles, do you speak English?
All the small things,
all
please.
The small things we will ask you about. The answers to the following will include the word small. Infectious disease caused by the virus variola major or variola
smallpox.
Minor. Correct. It hears civil cases involving minor amounts of money.
Oh, it's small. Small claims court.
Correct. The notorious B.I.G. was also known by this name.
Biggie Smalls.
Biggie Smalls.
Correct. 15 out of 15 on the bonus. And there's the sound ending the round in a big round for Hanover as we come halfway through the game. As they take the lead over Plymouth 195 to 80, we'll take a timeout. Before we get to our 62nd round, we'll ask Lori to rejoin us. This time, she's going to be talking with the team from Plymouth Regional High School.
Thank you, Jim. We'll start with Andrew now. And you're actually a hockey player.
Yeah, I've been playing hockey since I was 7, I think. Yeah. I started skating when I was 3, and my dad actually makes a rink around my yard, and it's just awesome, yeah.
So everybody's at your house all winter?
Yeah, basically, yeah. The hockey team comes over quite a bit, and we go skating and play a lot of hockey, so.
Sounds like a lot of fun. Okay, and next we're talking to Isaac. So you have plans to create a time machine.
Yeah, my rationale behind that is that, I mean, it's a great way to explore history and talk to, you know, whatever historical figures you feel like. And if you see time travel as, you know, going with the multiverse theory of the universe, you don't have to worry about disrupting your own timeline. So, I mean, what's to lose?
Right. So, and if you come back and suddenly Plymouth won, we'll know why.
Yeah, exactly.
That's it. That would be funny. And now we have Zan. So you are graduating and going to?
Yeah, I'm going to Columbia University next year in New York. And I wasn't really expecting that. I got an early decision, and so it's a nice little Christmas present for me this year.
And New York is great.
Oh, yeah. And there's lots of opportunities down there. I was planning on going into film, maybe doing what you're doing.
Okay.
So
you're taken. I'll
take over now. But, yeah, it's going to open up a lot of opportunities, so I'm happy for that.
That's a great school, too. Let's see. And finally, we have Sean. So you spent last winter in Canada.
Last summer, yeah.
Oh, right, last summer, because last winter would have been way too cold.
I went to a city called Trois-Rivières. It's right in between Montreal and Quebec. And I went there for 3 weeks to study French.
Maybe next time you can go to France.
Yeah. I think I'm going back again this summer, too, so it'll be fun.
It will be. So enjoy that. And actually, right now, we have to go back to the game. So it's over to you, Jim.
And back to the game we come as we look at the team from Plymouth Regional High School. Coming up to round number 3, it's our 62nd round. We ask each team 10 questions in 1 minute. We give them 10 points for every correct answer and bonus them 10 should they get them all correct in under a minute. Both teams, Hanover and Plymouth, have their alternates up with them, so the entire teams are together. They can all talk, and we get through this round as we go to the team trailing, and that's Plymouth. So you can choose from Good Egg, It's a Lock, or Pushing Tin. Good Egg, It's a Lock, or Pushing Tin. And Zan, you can talk to everybody and choose one of those. Good Egg, It's a Lock, Pushing Tin. All right, Zan?
All right, It's a Lock.
Let's go with It's a Lock. And again, Zan, you can talk to everybody, but I do take your answer for the team. The answers to the following will all include the word lock. Start the clock. A wrestling move.
Headlock.
Correct. Who you might call when you've locked your key in your car?
Locksmith.
Correct. Scottish lake-dwelling creature that might or might not be real.
Monster.
Correct. You get a tetanus shot, so you don't get this.
Lockjaw.
Correct. English philosopher who influenced.
John Locke.
Correct. Where a soldier might put his gear in a barracks or a place to shop for shoes.
Locker.
Footlocker.
Correct. If you mindlessly fall in line with an idea or procedure, you could be said to be in this.
Lockstep.
Correct. A country with no coastline could be said to be this.
Landlocked.
Correct. This pendant can be opened and often has a photo inside.
Lock it.
Correct. You might put your sandwich in one of the bags.
A Ziploc.
A Ziploc. Sounds like a perfect round to me as they lock up 110 points. as we give them the extra bonus of a 10. So a good score of 110 onto the scoreboard. So Hanover, we'll see what you can do with good egg or pushing tin.
Pushing tin.
Or good egg.
Good egg?
Good egg. Good egg.
All right, we'll go with good egg. And Tobias, you've got everybody up there. You can talk to them all. The answers to all of the following will include the word egg.
Okay.
Start the clock. Sad I Am is featured in this book.
Green Eggs and Ham.
Correct. Town on Long Island featured in The Great Gatsby.
Pass.
Elaborate bejeweled object of art created for the Russian imperial family.
Oh, it's pass.
Some like to top this holiday drink with nutmeg.
Eggnog.
Correct. Instead of veal or chicken, you can use this vegetable to make parmesan.
Eggplant.
Correct. Smart people are sometimes called
eggheads.
Correct. You might get this crunchy cabbage-filled treat with your Chinese takeout.
Egg foo young.
Egg foo young?
It's egg roll.
Oh.
Some video games and movies contain these hidden surprises.
Easter eggs.
Correct. You could be said to be doing this if you urge or challenge someone to do something.
Egg on
is right. If you have done or said something embarrassing, you
egg on your face.
You got it, judges. Seven out of ten on their 60-second round. So round three ends, and the game tightens up just a little bit as a result of that, as our score right now reads Hanover 265 and Plymouth 190 as we head now into our fourth and final round. Now, teams, pay close attention to this. In this fourth and final round, should you give a wrong answer, you will have 10 points deducted from your team's total. So be careful, be aggressive all at the same time. Here we go. We have a video question, so take a look at the video and take a listen.
The Chihuahuan Desert straddles the United States-Mexico border. Name the three U.S. states where it's found.
Sean of Plymouth.
Arizona, New Mexico, and Texas.
You got them. New Mexico, Texas, Arizona is correct. The 1937 Hindenburg disaster led to the eventual demise of this form of transportation. Tobias of Hanover.
Zeppelin
is right. This actress is known for her roles in The Parent Trap, Mean Girls, and Zan of Plymouth.
Lindsay Lohan.
Lindsay Lohan is correct. Paper and pencil in front of you if you should need it. How much interest would a borrower pay back to the bank at the end of 3 months on a $1,000 loan at the interest rate of 6% a year compounded quarterly? How much interest would a borrower pay back to the bank at the end of 3 months, Ben of Hanover?
$60.
Plymouth? We were looking for $15. Before he became president, this man was part owner of the Texas Rangers. Sean of Plymouth.
George Bush.
George Bush is correct. This fast-paced and... I'm told more specific.
George Bush Jr.
Well, there you go. George Bush Jr., judges.
George Walker Bush.
Then he said Walker Bush. After three tries, I'm going to give it to him. George Bush, George W. Bush is correct. All right, let's continue. Union Major General George Meade's Army of the Potomac defeated Confederate General Robert E. Lee's Army of Northern Virginia in this battle, considered by many to be a turning point in the Civil War. Zan of Plymouth.
Battle of Gettysburg.
Battle of Gettysburg is correct. We have 2 minutes to play in our game. The surgeon's photograph of this lake-dwelling creature was taken in 1934 and is widely believed to be a fake. Tobias of Hanover.
Loch Ness Monster.
Yeah, there we go again. The Loch Ness Monster is correct. Before he became the first African-American Supreme Court justice, Sean of Plymouth.
Marshall.
Thurgood Marshall is correct for your 10 points. In 2002, this singer became the first winner of American Idol. Andrew of Plymouth.
Kelly Clarkson.
Kelly Clarkson is correct. This novelist was named after Ralph Waldo Emerson. His novel, Invisible Man, looked at issues facing Tobias of Hanover.
Oh, it's not H.G. Wells. No answer.
Plymouth, I can repeat for you. This novelist was named after Ralph Waldo Emerson. His novel, Invisible Man, looked at issues facing African Americans in the early 20th century. It was Ralph Ellison. 1 minute to go in our game. This particle accelerator located near Geneva, Switzerland. Tobias of Hanover.
CERN.
Say again.
CERN? C-E-R-N?
No, that is incorrect. This particle, okay, Isaac?
The Large Hadron Collider.
Large Hadron Collider is correct. According to legend, he killed his brother in a fight when they couldn't agree on where to locate Felix of Hanover.
Kane.
I can repeat it for Plymouth. According to legend, he killed his brother in a fight when they couldn't agree on where to locate Rome. Sean.
Remus.
It is Romulus. In 1861, Confederate Vice President Alexander Stevens gave this speech defending slavery and laying out the Confederate case for civil war. It was the cornerstone speech. Mogadishu is the capital of this African nation, Raj of Hanover.
Ethiopia.
Plymouth, Mogadishu is the capital of this African nation located in the Horn of Africa. And that's it. The sound of the horn rings, and what a up and down fourth round it was, and as a result, a comeback for Plymouth as they win 250 to 235 in our game tonight. One to the played game, very exciting right to the wire, everybody. Hope you had a good time at home watching this one. Hope you'll be back again next week for our eighth and final opening round game, as it will be the team of Green Wave of Dover High School against the Little Green of Manchester Central High School. That's our game next week. Thanks for watching. Good night, everybody.
Major funding for the production of Granite State Challenge has been provided by Unitil, Energy for Life, NEA New Hampshire, with additional funding from D.F. Richard, Markham Image, Heinemann Publishing, Measured Progress, the NEEF Networks for College Planning, and by viewers like you. Thank you.